The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 18, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
Dehinasmin yathadehi kumaran jovanam jada तथा देहांतर प्राप्ति धीर सत्व नमय दे सेकंड चैप्टर इज ए समरी स्टडी ऑफ द भगवत गीता द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज ए प्रिपरेटरी स्टडी ऑफ भगवत गीता एंड द सेकंड चैप्टर इज ए समरी स्टडी ऑफ द कंटेंट्स भगवत भगवत गीता मीन्स द सॉन्ग सांग बाई द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड भगवत फ्रॉम द वर्ड भगवत वी स्पीक भगवान भगवान Here in the Bhagavad Gita, you'll find everywhere, Sri Bhagavan Uvas. So, it is the science of understanding God. Jat vijnana samannitam. Jnanam te prabhakshami jat vijnana samannitam. It is a vijnana. Vijnana means science. As everything is understood thoroughly through a scientific process, similarly, if you want to know the science of God, then you have to adopt the process by which one can understand God. That process is described in the Bhagavad Gita Bhaktya mam avijanati. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he says, if anyone wants to understand me, then he has to take the process of devotional service. Not by the speculative process or by fruitive activities, or by yogic process, mystic yogic process. It is clearly stated, not only in Bhagavad Gita, in all other Vedic scriptures, athāpi te deva padāmbujat vayam prasāda leśānu grihita eva hi jānāti tattam bhagavan mahimna nacāna ekopi chiraṁ vichinna. One can understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead by His mercy only. Athāpite deva padāmbujadnam prasāda leśānu grihita eva. Anyone who has received a small particle of the prasāda, mercy of the Lord, he can understand the law. Nobody can understand the law perfectly. It is not possible because the Lord is unlimited. We have got our senses very limited. Our senses are not only limited but also imperfect. We commit illusion. We try to cheat. So many defects are there. Therefore, simply by exercising our senses, it is not possible to understand God. So, to know God, God is very good, God is great, that is another thing. The science of God, just like Bhagavad Gita, by studying Bhagavad Gita, we know not only God is great, but we see what kind of God He is, what is His form, Sachidananda Vigraha. We have heard in the Shastras that Ishara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Dadi Govinda Sarvakarana Karana. Now, that Ishara, Sachidananda Vigraha, how he appears, Sachidananda Vigraha. Those who are present, of course, they saw the Sachidananda Vigraha. But because not all of them were devotees, they could not understand Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. Abhijananti mana mudha manasin tanumasitam. Because he appears just like a human being, so mudhas means less intelligent, or in plain word, ass. Mudha means ass. So this class of men could not understand Krishna, that he is the Supreme Personality of God. That is the defect of the Murad. They may be very great scholar, academic scholar, but in the matter of understanding God, they are Murad asses. Why? Maya apurita jnana asuri bhavamasita. At the present moment, people are mostly asuri bhavamasita. Asuri bhav means to defy God. There is no God. God is there. I am God. You are God. So many gods are loitering in the street. Why you are finding out God? These are so many statements. The God has become so cheap. There are so many incarnations of God. especially in India, it is a breeding ground of gods, so many. So that is means they do not know what is God. Mura. They think God is so cheap thing. But from this Shastra, we understand. From Bhagavad Gita, we understand. When Krishna was asked by Arjuna, how you are controlling the whole cosmology, your vibhuti, your power, your energy. So Krishna explained, and at last he concluded, Atabha bhaunaitena kingyatena tavajna. Vishyabhya aham idam krishnang ekanshena sthitu yava. The whole cosmology, material world, is just sustained by my partial manifestation of energy. Ekanshe. This material cosmology, material manifestation, is one-fourth demonstration of God's energy. The three-fourth manifestation of His energy is the spiritual world. Parastasmatubhavanya bhaktya bhaktya sanata. There is another nature which is spiritual nature, para, superior. The spiritual nature is described as para. Para means beyond this, apara. There are two energies working, material nature and spiritual nature. Material nature is described in the Bhagavad Gita, bhumi rapa analo bayu khangamana buddhi riva. Bhinname prakriti asadha. These eight types of material nature, earth, water, fire, air, sky, mind, intelligence and ego. These are material nature. Bhinna prakriti asana. They are separated energies. aparayam itasu vidhi me prakritim para. Beyond these are inferior opera. And beyond this opera prakriti, there is another superior prakriti. What is that? Jiva bhuta mahabaho jayidam jhadati jagat. That is the living entity. The living entity, living being, is energy of the Supreme Lord. Energy, just like the sun and the sunshine. Sunshine is the energy of the sun glow. Similarly, we living entities, we are also energies of the Supreme Lord. What is the sunshine? It is a combination of a very small shining particle, molecule. That is sunshine. It looks like one homogeneous thing, but they are small particles. That is scientific understanding. Similarly, we are also a small particle of the Supreme Lord. Mamai vāṁsa jīvahu. We are a small particle. How much small? What is the magnitude? That is also described in the sāstra. Kesāgra satabhāgasya satadhā kalpitasya jīva bhāga sabhigyaya sa anantāya kalpa. There is dimension of the living entity. 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. So it is very difficult. With our this material eyes, we are very much proud of our eyes. But here is the indication from the Shastra, the length and breadth of the living soul. Now we find out with your eyes, your microscope. That is not possible. Because they cannot find out, they say nirakar. Nirakar, in one sense, it can be supported that we cannot ascertain the forms of the soul. And what, how we can ascertain the form of the Lord? Anoraniyan mahato mahiyan. So, spiritual education means, spiritual enlightenment, first of all, we must try to understand the jiva, because jiva is a small particle of the Lord. So that we can understand the quality of the Lord. Just like if you taste a small particle of gold, then you can understand the composition of gold. If you taste a little drop of water from the ocean, you can analyze the chemical composition of the sea. Similarly, if you can analyze the characteristics of the living entity, then you can at least understand what is God, what is the characteristics of God. Therefore, the beginning of spiritual education is to understand oneself, the self-realization. How to realize self? We have to take knowledge from others. Knowledge means to acquire knowledge, to learn from the teacher. So here is the supreme teacher, Krishna. Krishna is accepted as the supreme teacher by everyone. By all the great sages, formerly, like Vyasdev, Narad, Devala, Usita, and all other great sages. And recently, in the modern age, by our acharyas, Sri Ramanujacharya, Madhyacharya, Ramanujacharya, Shankaracharya, Vishnu Swami, all these great sages, great acharyas, they came from your South India. So you are fortunate in that sense. So we have to follow the acharyas. All these acharyas except Krishna, the Supreme Lord, all these others. And lately, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 500 years ago, he also accepted the Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna Su Bhagavan Sam. That is the acceptance in the Srimad Bhagavata. Similarly, Lord Brahma also accepted Krishna, Ishara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha, Anadi Radhi Govinda, Sarva Karana Karana. So we have got so many evidences. So we have to accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. There is no doubt about it. But why people do not accept? Why, as so many big scholars and big scientists, why they do not accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God? That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita, how these people do not accept. The statement is there, Namana duskitanam murha prapadante naradhama. Maya apurita jnana asuri bhavamasi. Those who are duskritina, sinful. Duskritina. Kriti means meritorious. And duh means miscreants. Meritorious for mischief making. Everyone has got merit. The mischief maker, he has also got merit. But one who uses his merit for mischief making, just like a great rogue, a thief, when he steals, he requires brain. So he is applying his brain how to steal tactfully, how to become a great rogue tactfully, how to become a smuggler. They require also brain. So, the bread is being misused for mischievous activities. They are called miscreants, duskritina. So, those who are duskritina, namanga prapadanta, namanga duskritina mura. One class is duskritina and the other class is mura. Mura means less intelligence or no intelligence. Namanga duskritina mura. Prapadante Naradhama, and Naradhama means the lowest of the mankind. And Maya Aparita Jnana, those whose knowledge have been taken by Maya, Asuri Bhavamasita. These classes of men do not surrender unto Krishna. We are not manufacturing these words are in the Bhagavad Gita. If we study Bhagavad Gita, we have to accept the statements, Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita means the speeches which is delivered or the song which is sung by the Supreme Personality of God. So, our Krishna consciousness movement is to preach all over the world that Krishna Stu Bhagavan Swayam. You are searching after God. You are taxing your brain so much. But in spite of taxing your brain, you say sometimes that there is no God, or God is dead, or everyone is God, and so on and so on. But our proposition is that why you are taxing your brain? Here is God. Here is God Krishna. By authorities, by Vedic version, by his activities. If we read life of Krishna, we can see that he is Krishna, God, from the very beginning of his birth. God is not manufactured by some mystic power. God is God. A dog is dog. A dog cannot become God. God cannot become dog. That is the difference. So Krishna was God from the very beginning. As soon as Krishna took birth, he appeared in 400 Vishnu Murti. But when he was prayed by his mother, to become an ordinary child, he became an ordinary child without two hands. So that is God from the very beginning. Not that by attaining some mystic power one can become God. You can have some power, godly, you have already power, because we are, every one of us is the part and parcel of God. Therefore, godly qualities are there. But you cannot become 100% God. That is not possible. They have been analyzed. All the demigods and living entities, they have been analyzed by great stalwart people. And it has been found that Krishna is 100% God. Krishna su Bhagavan sam. Iti changsakala pungsa Krishna su Bhagavan sam. All others, there are many other gods. And then God means not the supreme God. Ishara Parama Krishna. We are speaking of the Parama Ishara or Parameshara. There are two words. Ishara Parameshara. Atma Paramatma. That Param is God. We are Brahma Parabrahma. So Parabrahma, Paramatma, Parameshara, all these are applicable to Krishna. Just like Arjuna, after hearing Bhagavad Gita, he admitted, Parabrahma Param Dhamma Pavitram Paramam Bhava Purusham Sashatam Adyam. That is the position of Krishna. Adi Purusham. Govindam Adi Purusham. Krishna also said in the Bhagavad Gita, Aham Adirhi Devanam. Devanam. Brahma Vishnu Mahasa. Then after Brahma Vishnu Mahasa, there are other demigods, Indra, Chandra, Varuna, so many. So, Krishna says, Aham Adirhi Devanam. Aham Sarvasya Prabhava. He is the origin of everything. Aham Sarvasya Prabhava. Matta Sarvam Pravartate. Everything emanates from me. In the Vedanta Sutra also, the absolute truth is described as Janmadvasya Jata. The absolute truth is that from whom everything emanates. So here is Krishna. From sastric evidences, by his opulences, by his power, because Bhagavan means full of six opulences. Aishadjasya samagrasya bidjasya jasasya sriya. He must be the richest. He must be the strongest. He must be the most famous. He must be the most beautiful. He must be the great renouncer in this way. That is the definition of God. So, that definition is confirmed by Lord Brahma. Ishara Parama Krishna. Ishara means controller. Controller, unless one is powerful, how he can control? So every one of us is small controller. Somebody controls in his office, somebody controls in his family life, somebody controls a few factories. There are controllers, but nobody can say that I am the supreme controller. That is not possible. The supreme controller is Krishna. So this Krishna consciousness movement means we are trying to link up our connection with the supreme control. We do not wish to become the controller. We want to be controlled, but by the supreme controller, not by others. That is our proposition. Just like generally one who is in service, he hankers after government service. Because it is natural conclusion that if I have to serve somebody, why a petty merchant? Why not take government service? So that is our proposition. that we have to serve. We cannot do but serve any one of us. That is our constitutional position. Any one of us, we are sitting here. We are servants. Every one of us is servant. So our proposition is that you are servant in any case. Why not become servant of God? That is our proposition. That is Krishna consciousness movement. So, kamadinam kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidisa. We are servant of our senses. Kam, krodh, loh, moha, mastrajya, all this. By dictated by our lusty desires, we do anything which is abominable. Tishan kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidesha. So we are servants, everyone. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Jiver sarupai nitya Krishna da. Our real constitutional position is that we are eternal servant of God, Krishna. That is our position. But in this material condition of life, every one of us trying to become the master. That is the struggle for existence. Everyone is trying, I shall become the master, I shall become the supreme. But our position is servant. So this is called illusion. I am not master, I am servant, but I am trying to become master artificially. That is struggle for existence. And mukti means, liberation means, when you give up this wrong idea that I am master and try to become the servant of the Supreme, that is called liberation. Liberation does not mean that after liberation we will have a big gigantic form or so many hands, so many legs. Liberation means to become liberated from the wrong consciousness. That is liberation. The wrong consciousness is that I am master. So we have to change this consciousness. That is Krishna consciousness movement. One has to understand thoroughly that he is not master, he is servant. He is completely dependent on the supreme will. If we draw surrender unto the supreme will, then we have to surrender unto the will of Maya. We have to remain a servant. If we reject service or servitude of the supreme law, then we have to become the servant of the senses. That is Maya. Actually, that is going on. The whole world is serving different types of senses. Senses are one, the same, but they have got different desires. So they are servants of different desires. Now the Krishna consciousness movement is, it is not manufactured by us, we get it from Bhagavad Gita. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam braj. Krishna says that you give up all this nonsense desires, you surrender everything. That is the whole purpose of Bhagavad. We are dictated by different types of desires, which is dictated by Maya, and we want to become master falsely. This is called illusion. This is called Maya. Actually, you are not master. How we can become master? Because we may be very scientifically advanced. We may manufacture very wonderful machines and weapons. But after all, we are subjected to the rules of Maya. Janma mrityu jarabhyadhi dukkho dosha anudarsana. You cannot get out of these four principles of Maya's machinery. Janma mrityu jarabhyadhi. In the Srimad Bhagavatam it is said, jannera vindakha vimukta manina. They are thinking that they have become liberated, become Narayana or God. Manina. They are thinking like that. Actually they are not. Because they are subjected to the rules of the material nature. They cannot get out of this classes. And who can get out of these clutches? Mameva ja prabandanti. Krishna says, anyone who surrenders unto me, daividhi sadhanamai mama maya durutvaya, mameva ja prabandanti, maya me tang sarantite. So therefore, this Krishna consciousness movement is very pious movement, the most glorious welfare activities, and we are preaching this movement all over the world just to place Krishna. Our only ambition is that to place Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. That is our purpose. We don't want to become Krishna, but we want to become the most obedient servant of Krishna. That is our purpose. So we invite everyone from all parts of the world, and they are coming, they are joining. So in India, Krishna appeared. India has got special advantage to understand Krishna, and India has neglected. That's a great misfortune. But we request everyone to join this movement, study the philosophy, and become happy. That is our proposition. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.